and the Bake. Tropicana sponsors Food on 4.
This is Cambodia. Here, 80% of the population live in small rural communities, and black pepper is the cornerstone of cooking. Chefs Emma and Stevie are here to discover how the local people grow and cook their national treasure. They've traveled 100 miles south of Phnom Penh to the heart of Cambodia's pepper-growing district, Kampot. Pepper is grown all over Cambodia, but Kampot pepper is said to be the best in the world. They're heading to Starling Farm, a 5-acre pepper plantation run by Anna Him and her family.
Hello.
Hi.
Welcome to the plantation.
Thank you.
When the French ruled Cambodia, pepper from Kampot was world famous and graced all the finest tables in Paris. Today it's rare, but highly prized for its floral bouquet.
Oh, look, tiny pepper.
Oh, look. There's a bit of pepper. Nice.
Peppercorns are the fruit of the climbing vine Piper nigrans. Originally from India's Malabar coast, the vines have thrived in Cambodia for over 700 years.
Okay, this soil is perfect for the pepper because the soil, as you can see, damp like water and stuff. So it's
quite
perfect.
Dry.
Yeah, that's good. They don't like a lot of water. Why it just dies straight away?
So why have you got all this green netting over the top?
They're a natural plant. They used to grow in a jungle
around a tree. Oh. So it's like have enough shade for them. So,
like
that's
a jungle
right.
canopy.
Yeah, like a, yes.
God, they really are sensitive, so you have to choose your spot, almost like growing wine.
I think maybe wine is more easier than pepper.
Oh, really?
Yes, pepper is very difficult.
You have to look after them like a baby.
Kampot pepper is called the champagne of pepper because, like the drink, it can only be grown in a specific area. The mineral-rich soil and abundant sunshine in Kampot produce black peppercorns that are unusually fragrant. To meet increasing demand, Anna has constructed a jungle of 300 brick columns to support her new vines.
I love it in the pepper forest. My God, it's like a maze.
Yeah, it is.
Yeah,
it is.
It's very
kind of daunting almost.
Now we're ready to do some work.
To strengthen new vines, the flowers must be picked for the first year.
This is my uncle. He's going to show you how to pick the flower.
Okay.
Down.
So how do we know which ones to pick?
All of them down.
You have to take every single flower off every single plant.
Yes, yes.
That is a lot.
It's all yours.
One just to throw away so that the energy from the tree doesn't all go into the pepper.
Yeah, because the first year plant need their own energy, so they're too young to produce yet. So that's why we want you to help to pick all the flowers.
Picking the flowers now ensures that in a year's time, every one of these 15,000 vines will be covered in bright green berries. Red berries are the fully ripened fruit of the pepper vine.
Peppercorn is ripe, so you dry in the sun, it becomes very dark red.
Ripe berries aren't used for black pepper as their flavour is too mellow.
Sweet, have a sweetness, like the skin outside is sweet. I don't know, the bird like it.
Good? It's good.
Mm. Mm.
Should we try the green ones?
It's the green, unripe berries that are used to make black pepper.
Sweetness. Not as sweet.
When they're green, they're spicy. Pepper's spicy compound piperine is from the same family as capsaicin, the source of chili peppers' heat.
Do you want some water?
It packs a powerful punch.
Completely different from black pepper.
Yeah. I've still got the kick.
The spicy green berries can be pickled or frozen to retain their freshness, or transformed into aromatic black pepper by the blazing Cambodian sun.
How long does the black pepper dry for?
It's about a week. And it's this lady turning it.
You have to turn it a couple hours, you have to turn
every few hours, as much as that. Yeah.
Blanching then drying the pepper forms a husk, which keeps the spicy compounds and essential oils trapped inside. White pepper is from the same berries left longer on the vine, but stripped of their husk. The flavour of black pepper ebbs away the moment the husk is broken, so it should always be ground fresh. It's the freshly ground pepper's spicy aroma that's inspired this fiery chicken curry.
You don't need tons and tons of different spices to make a really flavoursome curry. You also don't need chili.